Hello students, welcome to lecture number 21 on total quality management. In today's lecture, we are going to start with another principle, that is last quality management principle, relationship management. To welcome all of you, I am Professor Rishikesh Vikolle, working as an assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering in Sanjeevani College of Engineering, Kopargaon. Let us start with the lecture number 21. So, relationship management is having the following statement. For sustained success, an organization manages its relationship with the interested parties such as suppliers. It is very important that you should establish such a healthy, wise relationship, trustworthy relationship with the suppliers or with the customers also. Because all the interested parties that are influencing the performance of an organization. Because the sustained success is more likely to be achieved when the organization manages their relationship with all its their interested parties to optimize their impact on its performance. Relationship management with its supplier and the partner networks is a very particular importance is having, because to achieve the sustained success, you have to take the decisions, you should have good material resources. So to achieve the good material resources at the queue time, okay, you required this relationship establishment with all the peoples working together. You will receive following key benefits, such as first, you will get enhanced performance of the organization by if you are making the good relationship with the interested parties by responding to their opportunities and the constraints that are related to each interested party. Second, you can have common understanding of the goals and also the values among the interested parties, because all are working under a common goal. Though they are not your internal employees or internal party, they are external one, but they are helping you out to achieve your target. They are helping you out to achieve your goal. So that is why you have to establish healthy relationships. Also, you will get increased capability to create the value for interested parties by sharing the resources and the competence and by managing the quality related risk. Because the suppliers are responsible for giving you the quality at the resources. Because they supply, if they supply good materials, good quality materials, you will produce best quality products. Okay. If you receive, okay, poor quality material resources, raw materials, how could you produce good or better or best quality materials out of it? Products. Yes or no? So, there will be the risk, quality related risk associated with these suppliers. So, you have to accept this challenge and you have to maintain a good relationship network among all the parties, all the network, all the vendors working in your organization. Next, okay, a well-managed supply chain that provides a stable flow of goods and the resources. You have to establish a supply chain in your organization. Supply chain is nothing but it is a network of the channels from the raw material supplier to your sales officer. Okay, this is what supply chain. It starts with the raw materials. Then that raw materials you have to process in your organization. To receive those raw materials, you require the transportation network. So you should have good relationship with them also. whatever the raw materials you have processed in your organization, you will produce good goods. Those goods you have to again transport to the sales in the market. You require another team. So relationship you have to establish to have the stable flow of the goods and the services. Actions you can take. First, you have to determine the relevant parties, such as suppose whether it is a supplier, it is a partner, it is a customer or investor, your employee, or as a society as a whole. You should identify who is he. If he is a supplier, what kind of material you are ordering from them, and their relationship management is different. The relationship management with the partner is different. The relationship management with the customer is having another view, another angle, because you have to see that the customer demands are satisfied by your products or your goods. Also, you have to share your ideas about them. You have to take feedback for sound and healthy relationship. Your relationship with the investor is different, because you require the money for processing your goods in your factory. You require the funds at every time. So relationship investor is a different kind of thing. Relationship with the employees is also a different kind of thing, as they are also your employees, but there should not be bossing. There should be friendly culture should be there. Friendly relationship will create a common goal and you will going to be successful. And if you have the relationship society as a whole, that is the very good thing, because that will develop an integrity, and you will also establish the relationship, the mutual relationship between the supplier also and the partner also. You will also establish the mutual relationship between the customers and the investors also. You will also establish the mutual relationship between the employees and the investors also. So like this. So that will develop the good relationship management, and there will be the involvement of all the parties altogether working for a common goal. Next, you can determine and also prioritize the interested parties relationship that is need to be managed. Next, you have to establish the relationships that are balanced and that will have short-term gains with the long-term considerations. See, everybody working under the common goal, but there should be a short-term gains, and the relationship should be long-term basis. It should not be like this: he is our supplier and he need only for only small duration. This is not a thing you have to consider. You should establish a relationship as like you need this fellow for a long term. You may need him in another project. Okay, who knows? So future consideration you have to take. By considering this, you have to establish relationships. Next, you have to encourage, you have to recognize the improvements and the achievements by the supplier and the partners. You have to recognize them also, as like you are recognizing, you are encouraging your employees. Next, you can pull and you can share the information, the expertise and the resources with relevant interested parties also. You can share your expertise. I am knowing this is the new material which is available in the market, and another company in the market, they are using this. You should share this valuable information to your supplier, because he is not knowing these kind of things. He don't know the market. He only know the how to produce, how to supply the material resources to the companies. So based on this, you can share your expertise. You will also receive another valuable information from them. Next, you have to measure the performance and you have to provide the performance feedback to the interested parties as appropriate, because to enhance the improvement initiatives. So you have to measure this, whether it is healthier relationship or not. You have to take a feedback. Also, you have to establish a collaborative development and the improvement activities with the suppliers, partners and all interested parties. Because the relationship management altogether will help you in your difficult situation also and in your successful situations also. Because those the things which you are going to develop in your organization, that thing should apply to all the parties that are interested parties or interested customers, interested suppliers, partners, altogether. You have to apply them all and you have to recognize them all. This relationship management will help you out and will going to be help you in successful achievement of the project or the product. So this relationship management you have to establish among all. Okay, so this is the conclusion of all 7 quality management principles according to the ISO 9001. We have seen this is very updated principles. We have seen according to the update that is received in September 2015. Okay, so this is about today's lecture. Okay, in next lecture we are going to start with another topic. Till then, thank you.